Hi friends, this is Sivakoti Yelamachali and welcome back to my YouTube channel Technology Hacks. In this video, we will learn about creating a file, copying a text file, moving a text file and also removing a text file using terminal. Okay, let us see now. Open your terminal and change it to desktop mode. For that, use commands, change directory. desktop and press enter. Why I am telling is, if you are creating file, it will be on the path. It means after, if you are creating a file, it will be on this path. Just after opening your terminal, type pwd. This is our path. And if you open your terminal here, type pwd, it means present working directory, and press enter. This is our path. If we create our file, it will be on this path only. And if you are creating here, it will be on the desktop. Yeah, here we have the path desktop. Okay, where you can create the file, it will be on that specific path only. For creating a file, you need to observe carefully these commands. Just enlarge this. Now type the commands: cat. Do you know what is this? We should specify redirect symbol. It means a greater than. Here we can type file name .txt. Means my file name is tkh.txt. Just observe carefully. Yeah, cat tkh.txt. Here press enter. Did you see that the file is created? Now just open that file. Did you see there is nothing in that file? The cat command is not only used to create a text file. By using this, we can create, insert data into the file. Now enter the data here. For this, use this command. Yeah, did you see here? After typing this, here is some gap. Observe carefully. Here, enter the data what you want to give. Please subscribe my channel. For saving the data, press Ctrl Z. Okay, now we will see. Yeah, see here what data we are given. Here it will be directed to move to the text file. Okay, just observe carefully. Now we can modify the text file using same command. Yeah, type cat, use this redirect symbol, space, and the same text file tkh.txt. yeah, same text file, and press enter. The data given here is added into the text file. Yeah, it will be actually added to the same text file. I am giving thank you for watching. Okay, for saving, press Ctrl Z. Now open this text file. See here, the same data is available here. Okay, to open a text file using terminal, type the same command, but there is some difference. Now we want to open this tkh file using this terminal. Actually same command will be used, but there is some difference. Cat space
pkh.txt
means this is file name, this is file name, and this is extension, and press enter. See here, the file is opened, and that data in that file is clearly visible here. This way we will open which file you want using this cat command. By using cat command, we can easily create a text file, adding a text and open a text using CLI, means command line interface in terminal. By using touch command, we can create files. We know that not only for cat commands, we can also create a file using touch command. Just we will see touch sokoti.txt and press enter. See here, the text file is created. Okay, by using touch command we can create multiple files. Now I am creating three files. Just untouch Shiva, just Shiva 1 space Shiva 2 space Shiva 3 and press enter. Did you see that? Three files are created. Using this touch command, we can create multiple files. We can also create multiple files using this touch command. We can also create multiple extension files. Now we will see touch hi.txt. Here we are creating text file, and hi.sh. These are two different extensions. And press enter. See here. Sorry, I think this is, just give me a minute. Yeah, com is not available. Press enter. See here, two files are created, hi.txt and hi.sh. We need not give a comma between them. We have to give space in between them. Okay, now we will see. We can also create using this terminal, means observe carefully, give redirect symbol, and mention here file name and with extension, means sk.txt. Just we will move some, yeah, see here directly we are created. These are the ways to create a file. Now we will see how to delete a file. I know that how you delete a file, just highlighting the file and press delete button in the keyboard, or right click on it and keep delete it. Yeah, I am saying not that method. Using terminal, how to delete a file. But I will tell you deleting a file using CLI, means command line interface. I want to delete tkh.sh file, means sorry, I want to delete that tkh.txt file. Just we will clear the screen, type clear and press enter. It will clear the screen. I want to delete this tkh.txt file. Yeah, here it is. For that rm means remove. Here we can give file name, means tkh.txt with extension. This is the file name, and this is the extension. Now we see that file also removed, and press enter. See that the file is also removed. We can also check another one. Press RM means remove file name with extension. Press enter. Did you see that the hi.txt file is removed? We can check another one. Means use upper arrow for duplicate command. I want to delete this sk.txt file. Yes, this sk.txt file. Press enter. Did you see that the file is also deleted? This is the way to remove a file. Now we will see how to copy a file and move a file. Use the same syntax. Use ls to see list of screen. We will see the list of files and copy one command that I want to move this file hi.sh. hi.sh, and this is the file. This is the file and this is the extension. And later give a space, give forward slash. Here we have to give the path. Okay, I need to move it to this my home folder. To copy a command, just cp means copy. Here we will mention the file name that s.txt. This is the file, and here we can mention the path. I want to move to this to my home directory tkh. Actually this is my home directory. After here this is the file name. Yes, this is the file name, and this is the extension, and this is the path. After entering this, press enter. Yeah, I think it is copied. Yes, did you see that it is copied? Yeah, we will do once more. Did you see here there is no file. I want to move this to ins this file siva one. Okay, just type siva one. After that press enter. No such directory. Not start siva.txt. Sorry, this is not a txt file, so we cannot move this. So change the extension siva one and press enter. Yeah, did you see here the file is copied here in my home directory? We will see the files. It will be in home directory. The file is here. Now we will see how to move a file. That the syntax is same for both copy and move. For copy we will use cp, and for moving we will use mv. Now let's check. Here type the command mv and give space, and same here we have to give the file name. I want to give the same file name that siva.siva1, and this is the file name, and this is the path. Here we will see clearly that the file here is siva1. After that press enter. Sorry, I think the file is copied here. We did not change that. Yeah, see, I did not give here move command, so it will not work. I think it is copied there. You have to give move command, it means mv. After that press enter. see, did you see that the file is moved? Go to my home folder and see the file is here. I will delete these files. Okay, I will check another one. Okay, I will move shiva2.txt shiva2. Here you have to give mv for moving the file. Here you have to give the file name and here is the path. After that, press enter. See here, the file is already moved. Go to home directory and see here, the file is here. Yeah, it is only you have to see. Sorry, yeah, did you see that? Now we will learn about renaming a file. For renaming the file, use the same syntax, that is just type move. And we have to give here s.txt. Sorry, it is not the s.txt. And this is the file and this is the extension. And give a space, and here we have to give the file name, means what name we have to change. It means rename of the file. I want to change it to tkh.txt. Just observe carefully, this is s.txt. Now I want to change it to tkh.txt. After entering this command, press enter. Yeah, did you see that the s.txt file is changed to tkh.txt? I think you already learned these all topics, and these are the file management topics. I think this video is very useful. If you think these are useful, please like and share with your friends. If you are visiting my channel for the first time, please subscribe. These comments will be very useful, and practice it once. If you have any doubts, comment me below, and thank you for watching my video.